After knowing these strategies into the proper mass, first of all, we have to start the trading account. When we are going to start the trading account, it must be we have to enter some of the mandatory entries in our trading account. So I'm entering the mandatory transaction in trading account. Then after we are going to solve the private balance into fund labels. In the trading account, first is one, we have to mention two opening stock. Right? After that, second one, we have to mention purchase. Under the purchase, we have to minus purchase returns. In credit side, we have to write by sales. Under the sales, minus sales returns. S returns is nothing but sales returns. Now we have to see the performer. Right? Come to the first one, capital. Capital doesn't have any interest on capital, so directly I'm entering this capital but into liability under the balance sheet. First column, first word capital. Capital value 1,80,000. Right? And next one, drawings. Drawings is also close to liability, and this drawing value will be subtracted from capital. Minus drawings value 6,000. So all minus figures must be in brackets 1,74,000 equal. Right? And come to the next one. Plant and machinery purchased on 1st April 2009 70,000. And second machinery purchased on 1st October 2009. So there is a date identification for depreciation, means reducing the property value at the end of the year. So first of plant purchased on 1st April. 1st April to 31st March, 12 months. 1st October to 31st March, 6 months we get. So depreciation is depends on month calculation is important. And depreciation of plant and machinery value 20%. So plant one. Plant one value 70,000 minus 20% depreciation. Then how we calculate this 70,000? 70,000 into 20 divided by 100 into 12 divided by 12. 12 divided by 12 is nothing but 1st April to 31st March, 12 months. 2 months are 2, 70, 7 2s are 14, means 14,000 real out of 56,000 paper. Right? And again, this depreciation value will be converting into profit and loss account debit side here. 20% depreciation on first to plan, the value 14,000. Right? And come to the second machinery depreciation. Plant second, value 5,000. Here we calculate 56,000. And the separate value minus again 20% depreciation. 5,000 into 2500 into October to 31st March, 6 months. 6 divided by 6 ones are 6 twos are 0 0 cancel, 0 0 cancel, 2 ones are 2. 5 twos are 10. So 1000 into under the 1000, 1 by 2, 500. 5000 minus 500, 4500. Again, this depreciation value will be converting into profit and loss account debit side. 20% depreciation on second plant 500. Right? And come to the next one. Stock in dry balance, stock is nothing but it will be always called as opening stock. Opening stock 65,000 will be converting into trading account debit side 65,000. Right? And next one, purchase 1,82,000. Purchase also goes to trading account debit side 1,82,000. right? And come to the next one, sales 2,20,000. Sales goes to credit account, credit side 2,20,000, right? And next one, purchase returns 1,000, sales returns 2,000. Here we know purchase returns separate value 1,000, sales returns separate value 2,000. So those value will be converting into here. Purchase return 1,000, sales returns 2,000. 1,82,000 minus 1,000, 1,81,000. Here 2,20,000 minus 2,000, 2,18,000. Right? And next one, furniture value 5,000. Here we have start part, that is nothing but we have adjustment. In the last adjustment, depreciate 5% on furniture. So we have to depreciate 5%, 5,000 value on furniture. On assets and furniture 5,000 minus depreciation at the rate of 5%. So here we don't have any date of purchase, so directly we have to calculate on 12 months. 5,000 into 5 divided by 100 into 12 by 12, 12 months are 2 zeros cancel, 5 answer 5, 5 5 25, 250, 4,750 become. Again, this value will be converting into profit and loss account debit side. Here, 5% depreciation on furniture, 250. Right, and come to the next one, debtors. Debtors is also asset. Here we have start mark, that is nothing but we have adjustment relating to debtors. First of all, we have to write debtors in asset column. Debtors total 130,600. Now we have to see the adjustments. First adjustment, write off 600 balance minus bad debts 600. 30,600 minus 600, 30,000. Right? And next one, reserve for bad debts 5% on debtors. Again, we have to calculate. On this one, we have to calculate minus 5% RBD. I am giving abbreviations, right? Reserve for bad debts. Right? 5%, now we have to calculate on 30,000. 30,000 into 5 divided by 100, 2 zeros, 2 zeros cancel, 5 times are 5. 3 5s are 15, 2 zeros, 1500. 30,000 minus 1500, 28,500 return. Again, these two adjustment values will be converting into debit side of profit and loss account, that is, write off bad debt 600, reserve for bad debt 5% on debtors 1500. 2 bad debts 600 again to 5% reserve for bad debts 1500. Right? And come to the next one, credit cards. Credit card is nothing but liability. We don't have any adjustment relating to credit cards, so directly I am converting this value into liability column under the balance sheet. Credit cards value 20,000. Right? And next one, carriage outwards. Here, carriage outwards is goes to profit and loss account debit side. If carriage inwards is there, it goes to trading account debit side. Carriage outwards value 500. 2. Right? And next one, freight and duty 2,000. Freight and duty is nothing but direct expenses. Now all direct expenses will be converting into trading account debit side. Freight and duty worth value 2,000. Here we have to write 2 duty 2000, right? And come to the next one, trade expenses. Again, we have to remember, along with the trade expenses, we have general expenses. General expenses goes to profit and loss account debit side. Only trade expenses is there. This one is also goes to trading account, sorry, profit and loss account debit side, right? Then come to the trade expenses 800. Once again, I'm remembering you to how we have to consider this value in profit and loss account or trading account. Trade expenses is there. Along with general expenses here, we have in client balance, we have to convert general expenses in profit and loss account debit side. And trade expense will be converted into trading account debit side. In this client balance, we don't have general expenses. So this value directly converting into profit and loss account debit side, value 800. To trade expenses. 800, right? And next one, printing 400. Printing is also indirect expenses. This one is also comes under into profit and loss account debit side. To printing 400. And next one, rent, rates and taxes. This one is also indirect expenses. 4800. To rent, rates and taxes 4800, right? And come to the credit balance. Postage 600. Postage is also indirect expenses. It will also come under into profit and loss account debit side. Postage 600. Postage 600. And next one, reserve for balance 800. Under the inner column, we have CR. CR is nothing but trading column value. So we don't want to disturb this value. Directly, we have to convert this value into profit and loss account.